Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Lydia Stilou, and what I'm going to talk about today is the development of a mobile software application. The purpose of this app is to periodically record the course of Meniere's disease through the performance of automated audiometric tests. Let me start with some information on Meniere's disease. The triad of clinical symptoms characterizing the syndrome consists of spontaneous vertigo, fluctuating hearing loss and tinnitus. But what triggers it? Well, the precise cause of Meniere's disease is still unclear. The most common suggested etiology is endolymphatic hydrops, which essentially means increased fluid in the inner ear and can be observed at the bottom panel of this image. Another complicated feature of the disease is the fact that diagnosis is differential, and actually it will take several months to attain one. The first thing a doctor will do is to record the complete history of the patient's symptoms. However, reaching a diagnosis from this data is extremely difficult, as their reliability depends on the individual's good memory and objectivity. This is why patients are always asked to keep a diary where they record the Meniere's disease course. The main part of the diagnostic procedure includes pure tone audiometry. All of these PTA curves belong to Meniere's disease patients, and as you can see, there is high variability. A peak audiogram, that one in the center, is observed at 42% of Meniere's cases, and it is actually proposed as a diagnostic tool. This shape indicates a better hearing ability in the region of 1 to 2 kHz. Unfortunately, there is a major problem about pure tone audiometry, and that is the fact that hearing loss is so fluctuant. Patients visit the doctor's office many hours after the symptoms have subsided, but by that time, the audiogram shape may have changed. This figure shows 3 audiograms of the same person during a 24-hour period, and the differences are tremendous. Not surprisingly for this disease, ideal treatment is still absent. The syndrome shows a different pattern from patient to patient, and that's why proposed solutions should be individualized. Now, after describing the disease's features, I think the need for an application like the one we developed has been clarified. So, how does the app help a patient? First of all, it replaces the classic paper diary. The patient can record and evaluate symptoms and treatment methods. The other usage of Meniere's calendar application is the performance of automated audiometric tests. The task here was to find self-testing methods that are reliable. And after extensive research, we ended up in a series of binaural tests, 4 of intensity matching, followed by 4 of pitch matching. The main idea is to overcome problems like device calibration by measuring the hearing ability of the impaired ear compared to the unaffected, as Meniere's disease is mostly unilateral. The test procedure is very easy. The user listens to pairs of sounds, each one played at a different ear, and then answers the question, compared to the first one, how does the second tone sound? Now, about the sound stimuli we used. The first 3 tests of each set use sinusoidal tones of 250 Hz, 500 Hz, and 1 kHz. These sounds are also used during the classic PTA measurement. The 4th sound, however, is a stimuli of sine amplitude modulated white noise with modulation rate of 250 Hz and modulation depth set at 100%. The idea behind this choice lies in the theory that pitch perception results from the combination of both temporal and place information. place information created by the dysfunctional basilar membrane of a Meniere's patient may be incorrect, contrary to temporal information that remain unaffected and is actually used solely for pitch perception of some noise. I will move on describing the methods used during the test procedure. Each test goal is to best fit the data received from the patient's answers to a psychometric function. We did that using logistic regression. Then the point of subjective equality, which is the red marked spot, is calculated. This point corresponds to the intensity level or frequency for which the two ears perceive the sounds as equal. The tones presented during the procedure are calculated using a version of randomized maximum likelihood sequential procedure. The differences between the test tones and the reference tone, which is the horizontal line at zero, are at the beginning of the test easily noticeable. But as the time goes on, the test sounds get closer to the constantly calculated point of subjective equality, and therefore it gets more and more difficult to distinguish the sounds. The goal, of course, is to achieve better accuracy in the results. I will continue with the last part of my presentation, which is the research experiment we carried out. The participants consisted of 8 subjects, 4 with normal hearing and 4 diagnosed with unilateral Meniere's disease. The duration of the experiment was 2 weeks. Now, here, the intensity matching group results are illustrated as box plots. You can see the medians and the interquartile ranges. Meniere's patients require at all 4 tests significant higher intensities to obtain equal loudness than the normal hearing group. This is something we expected. In order to capture the hearing loss fluctuation, which is a diagnostic feature, we calculated the absolute average daily differences of our measurements. Meniere's patients show increased fluctuation at all tests except the 1 kHz test. This finding is actually encouraging for the reliability of our measurements, as 1 kHz is a frequency known to fluctuate less. And this result can also be associated with the presence of a peak audiogram, which I described earlier, and also constitutes a diagnostic element. Contrary to intensity matching results, pitch perception doesn't seem to show significant differences between the two groups. However, moving on to the absolute average daily differences, the clinical picture of Meniere's disease patients is here clear. Now, what I would like to discuss is the results of the sum white noise test. You can see here that the y-axis is set to 50% and daily differences of both groups are increased. This, in fact, reflects the difficulty of all subjects in perceiving the pitch of this kind of sounds. I should also mention that the fluctuation of the Meniere's patient's results is closer to normal hearing group, the normal hearing group at this test, compared to the 250 Hz test. In conclusion, Meniere's calendar app can not only be used as a diary recording symptoms and treatment methods, but also seems to be a very promising diagnostic tool. The ultimate goal, of course, is to collect sufficient data on this peculiar disease that are absent until now. That brings me to the end of my presentation. Thank you very much for the attention.